In this video, we're going to talk about Xfoil and how it determines and controls when to transition the boundary layer from laminar to turbulent flow. We'll start out with a quick explanation of the difference between laminar and turbulent flow and why we care where the flow transitions. Then we'll talk about the two methods that Xfoil uses to determine where transition occurs. Let's get to it. Why do we care whether the flow is laminar? Why do we care whether it's turbulent? And why do we care where it transitions? Laminar flow and turbulent flow have different properties. As you can see from this picture of the smoke that comes up from a candle, there is two distinct areas, the laminar area and the turbulent flow area. The laminar flow is smooth, it's steady, and the turbulent flow is very chaotic, random, irregular. When talking about airfoils, there is certain advantages to both laminar and turbulent flow. Laminar flow has a lower skin friction drag. This is because it has a lower shear force on the surface of the airfoil. Turbulent flow has more energy in it, so it's better able to stay attached against an adverse pressure gradient. And because of that, it's able to follow the contour of the airfoil better and ultimately end up with less pressure drag because it has a smaller wake. So really, there's a trade-off here between skin friction drag and pressure drag. Perhaps in a future video, we'll explore this idea more in depth, talking about golf balls and why they put dimples on golf balls. So the reason we care where the flow is laminar, where it's turbulent, effectively where the flow transitions, it's because we want to accurately predict both drag and flow separation. There are two ways that the boundary layer can be tripped from laminar to turbulent flow in Xfoil. The first is a forced transition, and this is just how it sounds. You specify where you want it to trip, and at that location, Xfoil will actually trip the flow for you. If you don't specify where you want it to trip, it's automatically set to trip at the trailing edge. The second thing that Xfoil looks for is what's called a free transition. This is an E to the N method, and this works in that you specify the critical N value and the flow transitions when the E to the N criteria is met for that N value. I have an example here on the left to help clarify. On the upper surface, we specified that we wanted to trip the flow at a chord location of 0.3. That's 30% of the chord. On the bottom, we didn't specify where we wanted to trip the flow, so it's automatically set to the trailing edge or a chord location of 1. For the free transition, we specified the standard critical N value of 9. And so as you can see on the upper surface, that's met towards the end of the surface, whereas on the bottom surface, it's towards the beginning. Xfoil will trip the flow when either of these criteria is met. So on the upper surface, the forced transition is met before the free transition, so it trips at the forced location. However, on the bottom surface, the free transition criteria is met way before our forced transition location, and so it trips at that point. I went ahead and marked with red X's where it would actually trip based on where the two criteria are met. So let's have a quick introduction to the E to the N method. This is just going to be a brief introduction. I'll probably make another video in the future that is a deep dive into the specifics of how Xfoil uses this E to the N method. The E to the N method looks at the growth of these two-dimensional Tolman-Schlitzing waves. It's kind of hard to pronounce. You can just call them TS waves. So the N critical value that you specify in Xfoil would actually be the N in that E to the N that you see there. We call this the amplification factor. And I went ahead and gave you some typical values for the N critical number. The standard method uses an N critical value of 9. And so in this method, transition is determined when looking at this amplification of these TS waves. And when that reaches this critical amplification factor, it's considered to have transitioned. Xfoil does allow you to change this N critical value. So let's go ahead and look at how we can do that. Opening up Xfoil, the first step would be to load your airfoil. Once you have an airfoil, you'll be allowed to drop down into the upper menu, and you can do that just by typing in upper at the command prompt. When you're in this direct operating points menu, you can go to the boundary layers parameters menu by typing in VPAR, that's VPAR, into the command prompt, and then you'll see it spit out the current values that is set for these boundary layer parameters. In this video, we're only going to look at changing the top three. That is the trip location on the upper surface, the trip location on the bottom surface, and the critical end value. In the video that we do the deep dive into the e to the n method that Xfoil uses, we'll look at some of the other values that are in this menu. While you're in this boundary layer parameters menu, you can change the trip locations by typing in XTR at the command prompt. It's going to then give you a prompt for the top layer. Here I went ahead and typed in 0.3 from the example earlier. Then hit enter, and then it will prompt me for the transition location on the bottom surface. I don't want to specify it, so go ahead and just leave it blank and hit enter. And that's it. We've changed the trip locations. To change the critical end value on the boundary layer parameter menu, just type N, and it will prompt you to enter the new critical application ratio. All right, I think that's it for this quick introductory video. Just a quick announcement. I created a new website called airfoildesign.com. Still really new. I'm still working on it. I've got a couple articles up, but I plan to have some more articles up on Xfoil and general airfoil design topics, as well as maybe creating some resources and tools that I can't really provide to you here on YouTube. For instance, this first resource that I've been working on is a list of all the commands in Xfoil. If you have any ideas for tools or resources, go ahead and drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your ideas, but in the meantime, feel free to check it out. All right, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.